In some natures, there are no halftones. Nothing but raw primary colors. John Bachman was a man who was always at one extreme or the other. This probably would have mattered little if had he not married a wife whose nature was an exact duplicate of his own. In some natures, there are no halftones. Nothing but raw primary colors. John Bachman was a man who was always at one extreme or the other. This probably would have mattered little if had he not married a wife whose nature was an exact duplicate of his own. Doubtless there exists in this world precisely the right woman for any given man to marry, and vice versa. But when you consider that a human being has the opportunity of being acquainted with only a few hundred people, and out of the few hundred that there are but a dozen or less whom he knows intimately, and out of the dozen, one or two friends at most, it will easily be seen when we remember the number of millions who inhabit this world, that probably, since the earth was created, the right man has never yet met the right woman. The reason that the divorce courts exist. And if two people happen to be united who are of an uncompromising nature, there is trouble. In the lives of these two young people, there was no middle distance. The result was bound to be either love or hate. And in this case of Mr. and Mrs. Bachman, it was hate of the most bitter and arrogant kind.
How are you, John? Long time, no see.
Not so good, I'm afraid.
Why? Is there a problem?
I'm so tired of my wife. I can't stand her. Life has become hell to me. I don't want to spend one more minute with her. I don't want to see her ever again.
So, why don't you just divorce then? You shouldn't spend your life with a woman you don't love.
I don't know our culture, my friend. I can't divorce her. I have to live my life with her till I die. Our marriage bonds us together.
You can leave her and come to Canada. You can stay with me.
Sadly, I must say that cannot happen too. What would people think about me? I have honor to preserve.
Then I can only pray for you, my friend. I hope you don't lose your mind.
Amy, I need to tell you something. This July I am planning to go on a holiday to Alpines in Switzerland. I won't be here for a month or more.
Why didn't you tell me this sooner? I would start my preparations earlier. You would feel crushed if you were to go without me, wouldn't you?
Sure, I can't even imagine something like that happening. I haven't been alone for a moment since we were married. You will never let that happen.
Of course, you know that I would never leave you alone. I know how you love spending time with me.
Tonight I shall find a place. Tomorrow is the game day. Where to start though? Finally, I will get rid of that whore Emmy. Maybe this is unfaithful, but we come to life once. Why spend it with the devil's secretary? Finally, I will be free, no one following, no problems. There wouldn't be any itching peas in my life. No worries, no one to fight with. No one. No one. Anyways, it will be great, I hope.
This is the spot.
And tomorrow morning is the time. What's the matter? Are you tired?
John, don't you think that if you had been kinder to me at first, things might have been different?
It seems to me.
It's rather late in the day for discussing that case.
I have much to regret, don't you?
No.
Very well. I was only giving you a chance. Remember that.
What do you mean by giving me a chance?
I want no chance, no forgiveness. I want nothing else from you. We are tied together and you have done everything you need to do to break off that bond.
We are tied together. We were tied together.
Why do you walk around like a wild animal? Come here, sit down and be still.
I walk like a wild animal because I am one. A moment ago, you were talking about how much you hate me. And now, your hatred is nothing to mine. I know there is no thought of murder in your mind, but there is in mine. I'll show you, John Bodman, how much I hate you. Yes, I have told all my friends in England that I believed you intended to murder me in Switzerland.
Good God, how can you say such a thing?
I say it to show how much I hate you, how much I'm prepared to give for revenge. Before we left the hotel, I warned the police officer that you are going to kill me, so they're about to come for me. When they come, good luck with convincing them it was an accident.
Convincing them to what?
This!
Amy! No!
I didn't do anything!